Hey, good morning. It's a beautiful November morning. It's been about 6 months since my last video, and I want to just show you how things did finally evolve. We went over areas and touched on things and discussed things. A few things I want to say first is I watch a lot of videos on homesteading, farmsteading, and a lot of them are with couples, but my husband and I do so many different things on this farm that most of the time we're not together working on stuff. We get together and share ideas and congratulate each other and give advice and have fun, you know, going over stuff. But most of the time, the hard work, we are alone. It's happened. I turned 62 and I formally retired, and I'm so excited. Cut my budget way down and I'm working on my farm, so that's really great. I also sold my beautiful 93 F-150 Classic with a Cleveland engine. It was a great truck. But I got myself a 17-year newer truck right here. She's a little beauty. And she's paid for, which is great. Came from a commercial line, my local Tri-County Electric. And it's great. It's just basics, roll down windows, rubber flooring. I could clean it easy. So I'm real happy with that. And it's 4x4 too, so it's great. So I'm going to put on my hat and stuff, and we're going to take a little walk, and I'll show you what happened. I'll show you what happened with the areas that I went over before. So here we go. Hey there. My worm farm is still doing well. The chickens get in and steal worms sometimes, but I always put all my compost under here and they eat it down to nothing, and I use this castings for everything in my gardens. All my potted plants here I moved into the greenhouse, except these 7 mulberry trees. So my shade house is a little quiet. I'll probably clean it up. Bob turned this area into a place to hang deer when he's cleaning any deer he catches or hunts or whatever. He laughs at me, I say catch, but you know what I mean, when he kills it. All right, and here's the greenhouse. I moved all the plants in here that needed to be in here for now. And like I said, the front was gonna be saved for that. We've got baby mulberry, green pepper, loquat, cilantro, fig, pineapple, more loquat. And in the back here, this is pretty much going to be a permanent area for what you see. I have tomato and jalapeno peppers and lemon trees. And over here are ponderosa lemons down there. I'm looking forward to these really taking off. And then, of course, we have our banana and our 3 citrus. I get oranges on them every year. We've had them for like 5 years. And I got stung by a wasp. I was reaching here to pull it down, to clip it, and that sucker got me in the elbow, and my whole arm and hand swelled up. So cool compresses, Benadryl. I had to go right to work on that. So over on this wall is baby lemongrass I brought in, but these are my moringa trees. I don't know how they're gonna do. This is my first time doing them in the greenhouse. And this is neem for the neem oil I wanna get from them. And this is papaya someone gave me. You know, we've been getting a lot of calls lately from very concerned, fearful, seeking friends and family. They just can't believe what's going on. But the Bible tells us all this, so you can just read it for yourself. But your peace is only going to come from knowing the Lord. That's it. So, sounds cliche-ish, but heck, you know, I used to say, I'm going to be miserable sometimes, so I'd rather be miserable in the Lord than out of the Lord. So, I'm sorry for everybody's troubles, but, you know, I'm trying to share my life and what I have, you know, to help others while I'm on this earth. So my son cleaned his little garden out before he went back on music tour. He's a musician. And the old tour bus. And over here, I have that area where the strawberries were. If you remember how beautiful those strawberries were. Well, they grew little shoots and I plugged them into the next holes. Then I put in these sprinklers and we cleaned out everywhere around here. I planted about 30 or 40, if you look real close, baby kale and mustard greens. They're all throughout here and over there in the other two planters. So this is what became of this area. The other thing I did is I planted 8 elderberry trees because we have elderberries all over the property, but I want to start like a grove. So I created the hole and you create a little mound around it and you fill it up with water so that the water seeps in. And I found out the best time to transplant some of these things, mulberry, elderberry, whatnot, is late fall because they're dropping their leaves, they're not fighting to grow, they're going dormant. So I was surprised with that. And if you're going to plant something that's been in a pot, you want to top it like in half just before you put it in the ground. So now let's go look at these sweet potatoes that we put into my tubs. Okay, this is the area of the sweet potatoes, and my goats are yelling, hey there. They love this weather. They think I'm gonna feed them. I'm not, sorry. So, the sweet potatoes have really taken off inside here. We did dig up one tub and they were medium to small size. So we're just leaving the rest of these for as long as we want. The leaves are dying back, so probably in the next month I'll just harvest all the sweet potatoes out of here. I harvested all those pineapples from all these pineapple plants. And I don't care if all those die off, I'm just gonna leave them and I'm gonna research if do they come back in 2 years and do more pineapples, I don't know. But they were just too much for me to handle. I'm gonna keep the ones in the greenhouse. These are my little pomegranate trees. And I'll be selling those when we go to farmer's market. Have a couple of these on the property. Supposedly you slit one of these red things open and the liquid you can use as shampoo. This area over here is way too dark. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it unless I get this tree topped or removed. So here's onions and garlic I planted. Come on, catch. So one thing comes to mind, Jesus said, will I find faith on the earth? Will I find faith? It's so easy to worry and take care of things. Sorry about the sun. It's so easy to worry and take care of things completely by yourself. It's okay to take care of things by yourself and think, meditate, take care of yourself. But completely by yourself without faith, you're just asking for trouble. So read the scriptures, get counsel, tell God you just don't know what to do if you don't know what to do. He's not going to let you die. He cares for the sparrow. How much more will he care for you, right? That's what the scripture says. So let's finish looking here. I did not grow anything in what I thought was going to be my tomatoes. I neglected them. They just stayed here by the fence line. This became a total mess right here, is what all this area was. After my bush beans were finished, I had planted a lot of flowers on this side of the fence line and they just took over. They all became these big weeds. My turmeric does well every year. It's time for it to die back. So it got nice and green and tall, and now it's time for it to die back. And across the little road here is Granddaddy's potato garden, sweet potatoes. We've been harvesting sweet potatoes, and we pull them out of the ground as we want to eat them. And we store them, we store a bunch too at the same time. So in a few weeks or next month before the frost, he'll go ahead over here, hopefully with Abby's help, our granddaughter, he'll go ahead over here and get more sweet potatoes. I have some volunteers. Volunteers are plants that come up that you really didn't plant them. They just decided to come up because they were left or planted by accident. And loofah is a sponge. I use it. That's all I use for my kitchen and bathroom. But boy, they can really take off and you don't know where they're growing, so you have to be careful. Fortunately, we don't have uncontrolled woods over here. Big, big one also, about 10 feet over. So I'm keeping track of these. I don't want them to fall into the ground and spread seeds for the whole year, so I am watching them. And this is just a burn pile. So that is the bulk of the work I've been doing. Doesn't seem like much, but every shovel full and pot packed and seed planted and hose turned on and off, it's all done by me, which I love the exercise and I love being out here in the morning. And I have my animals, my sheep. So really, I love my sheep over there. The goats were given to us, which they're growing on me. I'm hoping to get milk. It's going to be fun to try that. So, just to kind of finish, the changes, 6 months have gone by and all the work that was done, I think I did 90% of what I planned to do. Things get out of hand, weed-wise, but you just have to grow in pots, work around the weeds, use a weed barrier. And the pots, I think, are going to be a great strategy. And anyway, that's pretty much it. It's going to be getting ready for Thanksgiving in about 3 weeks. We're going to hopefully have Thanksgiving in the outdoor kitchen here. My son put this light up for me. My stove works in the oven. It's just a good place to sit. I get local channels there, watch Grit TV, that's the Western channel, and just hang out here until it's time for me to can. And we have a nice freezer, and I do my laundry out here. Anyway, I want to say thanks for watching, and please feel free to comment or ask any questions, and I'll try to record videos more often now that I am home more. Have a great day. Bye.